Hi, hello everyone. This is Squadron Jaisimha, your memory coach, the president World Memory Sports Council of India, only Indian with maximum Guinness Book of Records in the whole world. And you know that at Jaisimha Mind Education, we train students, adults, professionals, and memory athletes on basic, advanced, even the memory championship skills as well. And today, it gives me so much happiness and to invite my student Madhumita here to the studio. Madhumita, welcome. And Madhumita, she's studying, she's going to go to 10th class now in a place called Kamareddy, very close to Hyderabad. And she had gone through my basic memory workshop, advanced memory workshop, and one-on-one workshop as well. And then she keeps practicing every day at home. And I want to showcase her talent to all of you, because every one of you have seen what I can demonstrate in memory, but what Madhumita can do, I would like to show you. Madhumita, are you ready to show one demonstration to all people? Okay. See, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to show you some words, okay, random words. Okay, I'll show you some words. I'll give you time. You look at all the words. I'm going to show you 40 words. Look at all of them carefully. Memorize all of them. After that, you need to turn towards the camera and you should tell all the words back to me in the same order. Is that okay?
Okay.
Done? Yeah. So, you guys are excited? Ready? I'm going to show the words now. Madhumita, turn this side. Okay, look at these words now. Done?
Yes.
Madhumita, so turn towards the camera and I'll be cross-checking. Start from the first word and then keep coming down. Tell me.
College.
Yes. Dust. Yes.
Cement.
Yes.
Reserve.
Yes.
Road.
Yes.
Clouds.
Yes.
Shout.
Yes.
Theater. Draw.
Yes.
Marriage.
Yes.
Rain.
Yes.
Line.
Yes.
Coal.
Yes.
Gifts.
Coal.
Coal. Birds.
Yes.
Gift.
Yes.
Chair,
yes.
Trees.
Yes.
June.
Yes.
Photo. Sari.
Yes.
Fall.
Yes.
Cool. Dish.
Yes.
Cool. Dish. And old.
Yes.
Gold.
Yes.
Total. River. Trip.
Yes.
Ship. Plate. Meat. Nail. Oil.
Yes.
Plate. Beautiful. Fish. Fork. Fish. Fork. Teeth. Curtain organ.
Wonderful, Madhumita. Well done. Okay. First of all, congratulations. Now, I've given you 40 words, right? And you hardly took just 1 minute to remember all of them. What technique did you use? How did you remember all of them?
I've remembered all of them by visualizing method and journey method. And this is useful in my studies by reading a long answer in short way.
So, how do you apply this method? For example, now if I give you college and dust, so one word to the other word, you try to link them by using a story method.
Story.
And also use the journey method. One place, you keep dropping one item and then remember.
Yes.
And now this member demonstration is okay, but all my, you know, viewers, they want to know, if you want to become memory champion, like this demonstration is okay. But somebody says, I want to be topper in 10th class. I want to be topper in 12th class. I want to go to IIT. I want to go to MCET. Or I want to get into NEET exam. I want to become IAS officer. I want to have super memory. Or I want to remember the whole textbook. Now, these kind of words will not be there in the textbook. No, then what?
Not be there in the textbook.
Yes.
The whole lesson, we have some keywords now.
Okay.
By then, keywords, we are visualizing the keywords into visualizing method. So it is easy to remember a whole lesson.
Okay, what Madhumita says is, every paragraph will have one key idea, one central theme. So she will take out all those keywords and make a story, all that. So my question to you is, you have been with me for last 1 year and you've gone through basic program, advanced workshop, as well as, one-on-one workshop, online, offline, and you keep practicing every day. Religiously, almost 1 to 1.5 hours, she keeps practicing at home. Now, what is the difference that you have seen between you and your friends in the school?
In the school, if I used to read in only 1 hour, all the subjects, but they used to read one day and 2 to 3 days for a book.
Okay, so you are able to do it faster and is much more interesting. And using these techniques, Madhumita had got into the you know, Guinness World Records. And the second thing is, she also got into the Limca Book of Records for memorizing binary numbers, as well as solving maximum Rubik's Cubes as well. So she has got two records, right, in two different events. And also she is the junior Indian memory champion as well. And all that, now whatever she has done, achieved in her, you know, professional career, she's able to apply that in the textbook. So Madhumita, I want to ask you, do you recommend this kind of training to students?
Yes.
All right? Yes. You think they should spend time?
No, we should not spend time. We should spend time
in learning this technique. No, I am a student. I am asking, why are you necessarily wasting this time in trying to learn this technique, trying to remember all this? Instead of that, I can open the textbook only, I can read, no?
You can read textbook, but it is easy, no? It's an easy way to learn, no?
Okay. That means what Madhumita says is like a technique. Like you can go from here to the airport by walk. God has given every one of us legs. But why do we learn how to ride a bicycle? Why do we learn how to drive a bike? Why do we learn how to drive a car? Because once you learn to drive, then the distance will be the same, but time will be less. And you'll be much more comfortable in going to that place. So similarly, by using these techniques, it's going to be much more useful. Yes, sir, no? Okay. So what is your future plan, Madhumita? What is your future plan? What do you want to do in life? In memory as well as in a personal profession?
In memory, I want to be a memory athlete.
Okay, memory athlete. So my goal for you is that you should become world memory champion. Are you willing to put in so much of, you know, dedication, commitment, and then allocation of time? And would you like to become a world memory champion? Yes, would you like to become? And also, whatever career you choose, that also should be topper. Okay, so guys, you have seen Madhumita, how quickly within no time she's able to see unknown words she could memorize. If you have a kid at home, and if you want your kid to master these techniques, and if you yourself want to learn that, as a teacher, you want to learn this and you want to teach your children, or you want to become a memory athlete. So we have at JSMA Mind Education, we got online training workshops, we got offline training workshops, we also do one-on-one workshops. See, you will be able to get our numbers, jsma.in, and you can call up us on these numbers, and we'll be more than happy to help you to master these techniques. Once you learn this technique, road ahead in personal life will be beautiful for you, and you will be really appreciating yourself that you have invested your time and effort in mastering these techniques, and rest of the life you will have super memory, because whether you are a child or you are a teenager, adult, you should have beautiful memory. And Madhumita is one epitome of example, and 1 year time you have seen where she has reached, and a small little town near Hyderabad, and her parents, they put her through my training workshop, and with her commitment she has come up to here. So Madhumita, I wish you all the best, and I'm sure many more children and many more teachers, many more parents would get inspired looking at you, and they too might follow your path. And that's what our endeavor is. Okay? Thank you so much, Madhumita.